to the field of practice of notary. Indeed, the question we have tried to answer is as follows. Should wills and property titles be administered on the blockchain? The view from France. Before we begin, we will introduce ourselves. This is Cécile, this is Laetitia, this is Dorian, this is Sarah, and this is Alexis, and me, Camille. We are all part and our friends here in this room of the second year of Master Course Notarial in Nancy. For your information, Nancy is located just here on the northeast of France. You can see a picture of our class, and this is our university in Nancy. The notary, as we know him in France, with his qualities and skills, doesn't exist as such in common law countries like yours. So to begin, we will quickly explain the role of the French notary. So let's begin with the notary's role, and first of all, certification of notary deeds. Under French law, the notary is responsible for conferring authenticity to the documents he receives. It will guarantee four essential elements to this authentic deed. A certain date, this means it's a proof of its date with regard to parties and third parties. Probative force, the act contains undisputable facts with regard to third parties.
Guaranteed storage. In France, the notary ensures the conservation of the authentic deed in his own notarial office for 75 years. He only delivers a copy. Enforceability. It implies that in the event of a claim for a sum of money established in the instrument, the creditor may directly pursue the execution of the command entered into for his benefit. There will be no need for an execution judgment.
We are now going to see the comparison with the general notary in common law countries. Under English law, there are public documents concerning official business of public agencies or other public officials. Under no circumstances are statements made by private parties. A recent revision of the English civil procedure rules simply gives the signature of the English notary evidentiary force to certify private documents. It doesn't grant them the status of an authentic instrument. This English notary essentially has a certification function concerning the date and identity of the signatories. It doesn't assume responsibility for the content.
Moreover, the common law countries completely ignore the concept of an enforceable title based on a notarial deed. The passage through a court decision is mandatory for any civil enforcement procedure in favor of a private party. So the general notary is not empowered to create an enforceable document with respect to the debtor. He has to first bring an action before the courts. So the difference in the regime between these two types of notaries may lead to a different adaptation of the blockchain mechanism in their respective legislations.
Let's move on with the impact of the blockchain on the notarial profession. We will begin with a presentation of the evolution of French notaries due to the development of technology. First of all, you have to ask yourself, what is a blockchain? The notion will be explained in further details by one of my friends, so I will keep it quite brief. The blockchain is a recent invention. It first appeared in 2008. It was used for digital currency, the Bitcoin. While blockchain and Bitcoin were built together, today, many actors, like companies or governments, are considering to use this technology in other ways. Nevertheless, from a legal point of view, this technology raises some problems. That's why we are allowed to question ourselves about the impact of this technology and the possibility it offers to our profession.
The profession has been many times in the past been confronted to another technological advances. But through judicious adaptation, they have strengthened the profession. So the notarial profession has seen another major technological advances embodied in the decree of the 4th of May 2017. This decree requires notaries to file a certain number of deeds in the land registry by electronic means.
But today, it is around the notion of a blockchain that a notarial practice must get organized. For some people, it is a sign of the end of the notarial profession. This profession in France is characterized by the notion of the trusted third party. The parties rely on the third party to keep their agreements secure. The notary is appointed by the state and he offers the guarantee of the state. if we find another trusted third party, especially if it is free, the party save money. It's true. This is where the blockchain comes in.
Blockchain is a digital service shared by trusted people that records transactions through an encryption system. Is it just like a notary? In fact, no. The notary also provides advice. He drafts deeds in compliance with the law and ensures that they are truly effective.
So, is it legitimately possible to question the adaptation of the blockchain system in the notarial profession in France? To answer this question, we will see, first of all, the innovation that the blockchain brings to the profession before studying the real practical utility of this mechanism.
So, with a view to introducing new technologies into the profession, the Conseil Supérieur de Notariat, or CSN, or the Higher Council of Notaries in France, suggested the creation of a notarial blockchain. The principle of a blockchain adapted to the needs of the notarial profession was adopted at the CSN General Assembly in January 2017. And in October 2018, a prototype was presented to the court delegates. But what exactly are we talking about? In other words, how does the blockchain work? How can it be introduced into the French notarial profession? And what can be its interest, particularly with regard to land registration, as we know it in France?
We will begin with the introduction of the blockchain in the notarial profession. The technology of blockchain makes possible to certify transactions between individuals through a peer-to-peer system. Individuals deal directly with each other. There is no intermediary. So the system is decentralized and validates exchanges by consensus.
Blockchain can be defined as information storage and transmission technology, transparent, secure, and without a central control body. This process therefore consists of encoded information that will be validated by a certain number of participants in the blockchain. This information needs to be the same from beginning to end. As a consequence, a blockchain can be assimilated to a public and enforceable accounting ledger.
This ledger can be programmed more to record financial transactions. For instance, it can record everything of value, like birth and death certificate, marriage licenses, ownership, titles of ownership, or financial accounts. In fact, anything that can be expressed in code. That's why blockchain could be interesting to use in the profession.
So how does blockchain work? So transactions between network users are grouped into blocks. Each block is validated by the network nodes, like that, called miners, according to techniques that depend on the type of a blockchain. A node materializes the fact that this information has been certified true by a system of algorithms. in the Bitcoin blockchain, this technique is called proof of work and consists of solving algorithmic problems. As we will see, this technique was not chosen by the Conseil Supérieur de Notaire. Once a block is validated, it's timestamped and added to the blockchain. The transaction is then completed and permanent. It's visible to the receiver and the entire network. What makes blockchain unhackable? People credit this technological structure for this hack resistance. As stated earlier, a blockchain can be described as a chain of blocks. Each block appended to use previous block via some algorithm specific to the blockchain. Whenever a new block enters a blockchain, each computer in the network runs this algorithm, uses the previous block's value, and broadcasts its result to the other nodes. This structure boosts a blockchain security by ensuring that changing one block's value will mandate changing each of the following block's value as well. So, an example. For instance, imagine that a blockchain has sequential blocks A, B, C, and D. If a cyber criminal wants to extract data from the first block A by changing its value, this hacker will also have to modify the value of the following three blocks, B, C, D, because these values directly depend on the value of the first block A. As nodes continue to approve blocks and add them to the chain, manipulating each of the following blocks' values becomes increasingly more unfeasible for a data thief.
To develop the prototype for the Notary's office of a blockchain, it was essential to eliminate the public blockchain, the principle of a public blockchain. Indeed, it's incompatible with the profession and the rules of a notary. It's imperative, in fact, to provide the security to the customers. The solution of a private blockchain is also to be ruled out, since it will be only for the notaries. But this is not the desired goal. So, private blockchain can be created by consortia and be intended only for members of the chain.
It was therefore decided to hope for a hybrid version of blockchain, including a circle of trust that can be joined by both bankers and bailiffs who work daily with the notary. The profession has chosen a consortium blockchain based on the principle of proof of authority. Then, the consensus mechanism based on proof of authority makes it possible to determine in advance which member can validate the transaction and then be authoritative. Some nodes can thus made public and others remain private.
Now let's talk about blockchain and public registry in French law. First, a definition of land registry. In France, land registration has been part of our legal system since the 17th century. The French land register is different to the English one, because the French land register service requires all deeds of ownership and all rights of each property to be recorded. Thus, whether or not the transaction is for a fee, it must be published in the land registry service by the notary who drafted the deed. The service records the information in the deed to complete the records related of persons of real estate. This publication makes it possible to inform third parties of the transactions concluded and to make the deed enforceable against them. Nevertheless, this security of the purchaser's rights has a cost. The purchasers will have to pay the state a property security contribution equal to 0.10% of the sale price.
We could imagine substituting a blockchain for a land registry service. In this case, the information published by this service could be entered directly by the notary in the blockchain. The clients will no longer have to pay the real estate security contribution because it's expensive. It would increase the legal security of operation.
While the registration of transactions in a blockchain will be immutable, two nuances must be mentioned. They currently prevent the blockchain to become indisputable proof of ownership under French law. First, there is the Article 1198 of the Civil Code. It states that in the event of a conflict over the claimed ownership of property, the first person who publishes his right to land registration prevails, provided this person is acting in good faith. But how could a third person prove the bad faith of the registered buyer if in order to challenge his ownership right?
A second obstacle is that under French law, in accordance with Article 712, it's possible to become an owner by acquisitive prescription. But what is acquisitive prescription? The acquisitive prescription is the possibility of acquiring property by owning it for 30 years and sometimes for 10 years under certain conditions.
To take these obstacles into account, a mechanism should be invented to insert an open block into the blockchain that takes into account these unforeseen events. However, adding this block would affect the main quality of the blockchain, the immutability of the chain. If such a mechanism is put in place, the existence of the French notary could be in danger. Nonetheless, with deeds concerning real estate, only authentic deeds can be published. Currently, the presence of the French notary is essential because he must certify the conditions of the sale and the transfer in the land register. However, the security provided by blockchain could replace the authenticity.
For example, in 2017, the first real estate based entirely on a blockchain took place in Ukraine. It's the first time in the world. And it's very simple. You can install on your cell phone an application invented in Ukraine that it's called Probuy. And on this application, you can visualize the different properties, and you choose the one you want to get. And then, with this application, it will verify the property in the land registry and then generate a sales agreement, which in the future will be signed electronically by the parties.
The real danger for the profession is the development of technologies able to replace the notary in his verification missions. These technologies could most certainly take the form of artificial intelligence. In France, it seems very unlikely at the moment because the notary provides indisputable legal security.
Now we will study blockchain, the practical blockchain uses of the notary. We need to study how notaries can adapt and use blockchains to the benefit of their clients. A cautious mind will also check the benefit to use it regarding the limits stated by the law and the interest of their clients.
We will begin with the view of blockchain as technology useful for the development of the notarial profession. Blockchains allow to have secure transfers of information and funds. They can also be a time saver.
Firstly, we will talk about transfer tools. The technology blockchain offers the possibility to transfer any file swiftly while guaranteeing its content and source.
Notaries could apply the technology for enforceable copies. In France, the notary can deliver enforceable copies of a notarial deed. This way, a creditor is able to ask a forced execution without going through a judge. It is a time saving for the clients and for the court. However, only one enforceable copy can be delivered by the notary and it can be lost. The blockchain technology would allow notaries to track the copy. The High Council of French Notaries suggested banks and bailiffs be included in it to to allow a faster and more secure circulation of copies.
Blockchain could also be useful for money transfers. Indeed, it's reasonable to think that a person would be tempted today to pay via a cryptocurrency such as Bitcoin. Thus, this technology will facilitate money transfers between people. Notary receives them and then transfers it to the seller. This will make it easier for the notary to trace back the origin of the funds in order to combat money laundering.
Let's talk about smart contracts. Smart contracts are of significant use for the notaries. It could automate a large part of paperwork. Smart contracts are like the if-and-then function you can find on spreadsheet software. There are effects that will automatically happen when the set conditions are met. Smart contracts could also reduce both the risk of errors and the time consumed by those tasks. For example, when there is an escrow, the notary has to keep in his custody his client funds for a set period of time until the condition is fulfilled. With smart contracts, the funds will be automatically wired to the client.
Smart contracts could make the preemptive rights purge easier during the real estate transactions. There are multiple preemptive rights in France, belongings towns, for instance. Nowadays, the purge of rights is done by sending a registered letter. A proof of the day is requested by law. However, by using smart contracts on the blockchain, the request could be sent directly, thanks to the blockchain, and also the answer through the same process.
Smart contracts can also be used for planned operation and in the order to get some information. It could be applied, planned operation is necessary for a notary to get some information regarding the taxes of the property and any legal easement on it. When with a smart contract, notaries only have to obtain that demand, but in France, usually, it can take weeks. So again, it's time saving.
So now we will present the limits of blockchain. We established that there is a legal purpose of in blockchain, but how far can it be allowed? If notaries monopolies established by law, there must be reasons, but are they still justified?
Concerning such issues, it seems that despite all the theoretical benefits of a blockchain, boundaries remain in French law. In fact, a significant obstacle may be the legal formalities related to the solemn character of certain acts. For example, when a natural person wishes to act as a guarantor for someone, that person must draft a standard handwritten clause under penalty of nullity of the guarantee. So how will smart contracts ensure that the clause is correct?
The notary will check if a person who signed the mandate understands its scope and is in full command of his or her faculties. It seems difficult to think a smart contract will operate all these controls. It seems impossible to know what is happening behind the screen of the signatories. Therefore, a blockchain will be allowed for every contract.
Furthermore, it's necessary for a notary to make sure that every party of the contract is aware of its rights and its obligations.
Advice is the essence of the profession of notary. Notaries are professionally bound to ensure the effectiveness of the deed they draw up and to inform the parties on their consequences. People come to a notary to be advised as well as possible on their projects or difficulties. This bond of trust is essential and cannot a priori be replaced by a technology like blockchain.
Now, regarding wills, the blockchain can be a public one. It would violate the right to fully dispose of one's assets.
So the blockchain must be private between notaries. But is there a really need for a such blockchain in France?
That is a good question, Alex. Thanks for asking. A system in France regarding wills 1971. It's used for to try to centralize all the information that a notary must know, like which notary is in the possession of the will, where it was written, or how many consultations have been made.
To finish, liability. Notaries present a guarantee to people. If any mistakes entail consequences, the client can bring a lawsuit before the judge. There is a guarantee fund which all the notaries of France contribute. So if a notary is declared guilty for his actions, the client will be paid by this fund.
Can a client sue a company that creates smart contracts replacing notaries? If they can, on what legal ground? They don't have a duty to give advice enforced by the law like notaries. As we said before, a notary has some obligations. This is not the case with companies who will draft those smart contracts. It's not possible to sentence such entities.
So to conclude, it seems obvious to us that French notaries will have to adapt to new technologies like blockchain. However, they will not happen without taking precautions to ensure legal security for clients at all times. Thank you for your attention.
And if you have questions, we will try first to understand them.